up at noon, still aching from the previous job I had to do last night. Shit was serious. Got up out my bed and picked up my poinsettia and put him on the balcony so he could get a little bit of city sun just to quench his thirst. Plants gotta live too, cause they feed the earth. Just then I got a call from Pete / Linky Jones. He said to meet him down at Donnie's House of Pork and Bones and bring the little girl who people knew as Matilda, an orphan who I say before Gestapo could've killed her. Picked up my grip and let it slip into the holster. Although most of them niggas fear me, I'm supposed to protect my neck. If not, mine's in big PTs dipped in the door so no one can even see me. I told Matilda, wait outside for me, boo, cause a professional's always confidential. It's true. Then Pete said, yo, you know Mikey Butterfuco? The motherfucker cut my last shipment of bazooko and laced it with soda so much that you can taste that slimy Azu Pep's hands. I'll make him drink mace. I said, yo, boss, hit me with the sauce, send his whole family off course. Know what I mean? Just hit me with the green and I'll see what I can do to Mikey Butterfuco. He said straight, arrange a crew, but that's a no-no. The pro only murders solo. I almost lost my life working with teams out in Soho, California Beach. We were storming the place, fucked around and almost got bucked by Scarface, Tony Montana. But that's another story, a whole different chapter. Check the library. Went back to my crib, kissed Matilda goodbye. She started to cry, the sight brought tears to my eyes. The next day, made my connection, set my direction. My flight to Chicago, first class section. I didn't recognize no one on the plane. This was strange, my inside man was nowhere that I could claim. The stewardess was over polite, I wonder why. But I didn't give a fuck, this trick was mad fly. Speaking of fly, the pilot turned on the intercom, talking some kind of code, something was wrong. Everyone got out their chairs calmly and grabbed their stuff. I tried to raise up, but my seatbelt was stuck. Dig it. Cool, don't panic. I said, excuse me, my seatbelt's broken. Then the back door opened. Shit, I heard it closed and my belt unlocked. Turn around and there was four motherfuckers with Glocks pointed straight at my dome piece. Grabbed my chrome piece and licked two shots, leaving four men deceased. But how the fuck could two bullets kill four niggas? Checked out the cockpit, found the pilot's cranium disfigured. Then click, oh shit, another piece to my head bone. Turn around to greet Miss Cleopatra Jones. How you doing, baby? He said, I'm chill, how about you? Petey sent me as your crew, so what you gonna do? I landed the plane, checked in the hotel. Horny like a motherfucker from the whole smell. Broke to the bathroom to clean myself, then she snuck it. Naked to the pussy, straight up shower fucking. The walls were shattering with echoes, but ain't a question that killing motherfuckers ain't my only profession. Now after 2 hours, a killing crotch hit the sack. Woke up early to plan my plot. It was a mansion on the outskirts of Chicago. A clout clerk went by the name Mikey, but a Fuco didn't like me. Miss Jones was round the back, I took the front gates. Two punks on guard with Uzi strapped to their waist. Strolled towards a door, but Paisana was like, yo, who the fuck are you? Then I pulled out my knife slow, without a whisper or hint of hesitation. Made one quick slash and committed decapitation. Left the knife in the neck of the man on the left and hopped over the fence, took a short breath. It didn't take but a second to wait. The Rottweilers went psycho. I took one knee, grabbed my rifle and popped every last one of them sons of bitches. Motivated like a mother by the riches, but no glitches. Got to the door, which is the right button. Red, yellow or blue, push blue, then all of a sudden, I heard footsteps of at least three men running, sporting back tens, backflip under the porch. Pulled out my piano wire and wrapped it tight round my fist, made it quick with very little fight. Grabbed the fool on the right and silenced his ass. Nigga on the left, a strangle was his death. Motherfucker in the middle, playing the monkey, caught a cat sucking my barrel like a crack junkie. Got through the door and it was straight war. Camo, flawed gear getting torn by my ammo. Ran upstairs, tripping over dead thugs. Put they family to shame for fucking with my nigga's drugs. Upon the second floor was faced with three doors. Chose the first, a ninja master showing his thirst for my life. But little did he know I've been trained. Aikido's my middle name, put his ass to shame. Opened the next door and out came Kareem Jabbar, a barefoot size 17. I said, choose your style, a nigga said ostrich. Yeah, sure, nigga look more like he took one for hostage. Swinging his shits with no style at all. One swing of my sword left them 4 feet tall. third door opened slowly, only to show Cleopatra getting fucked by Mikey. But a fuco at gunpoint, the bitch turned straight to Heather Hunter on a steroid, banging this fool like she wants to. He didn't know I was there, so I moved around the front, rubber gripping, pointed at his dome, started tripping and bleeding with my ass as if it ain't my job to eliminate the families of punks who rob. Pull your dick out, nigga, this ain't no freak show. Let him go, cause he got touched by the professional. My flight was straight sex in the private jet, heading home to collect my $50 check. I'm out.